Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today, inshallah, we're going to use fit simulation to measure a speed of a wave using a string. So, I would like you to go to MS Team and download this document. We are going to use two ways to measure the speed of wave. The first one, using this formula, speed equal wavelength times frequency. And second one using the formula distance over time. Now remember, lambda or wavelength is the distance between two consecutive crest or two consecutive trough. Okay, so like here, this one and this one here down, or two points in phase. Like if I take, for example, this point is moving up, is oscillating up, this point A, this point B is moving down, and this point C, for example, is oscillating up. So the distance between point A and point C, this is lambda. So first we're going to fill these two tables. The first one, I have to change the frequency, and each time I need to measure lambda. After that, I can use this formula, lambda times F, to find the speed. The speed always should be same number, constant value. So let's try, I'm gonna try the first one. I will choose no end because I don't want any reflection. Damping, no damping, okay, because I need perfect, I need to get perfect sine wave and oscillate, okay? Put the ruler to measure the wavelength. And here I can play with the frequency, make it lower, make it higher. So I can make it lower till, let's say, 0.5. It's almost 0.5. Okay. Now, the distance here, if I take, this is a crest. Okay. And this down here is a trough. Let's do it again. And then, okay. Now here, this is a crest, and down here, this point is what is a trough. This is actually half lambda, half lambda. So this distance between 0 and 6 centimeters times 2, it will give you 12 centimeters. 12 centimeters, okay. 12 centimeters, this is will be lambda, converted to meter, so it should give you 12 converted to meter, divided by 100, so it's 0.12 meter. Multiplied by this value, so 0.12 times 0.5, it should give you almost 0.06 meter per second. Then you increase the frequency. Increase it to 1, I'm gonna increase it to 1.5. I will let you do the rest of the table. So I'll set it to 1.5. Okay, 1.5, oscillate, you see how the frequency increased, and okay, distance between two crests, this is wavelength, so the distance from here till here is around 4.2 centimeter, so here I have 4.2 divided by 100, okay, 4.2 divided by 100, so it should give you 0.042 times 1.5 times 1.5 should give you 0.06. You see, you should get the same speed. This is the first method. Now, second method, I'm going to use this formula. Distance over time. Distance over time. For example, I want to measure the crest when the crest move, okay, 3 centimeter, or when the crest move 4 centimeter. I have to measure the time, so I have to put the timer here. Okay, I'm gonna put it to slow motion. Okay, and I need the crest. Now look here. This is the crest. I need this crest to move till it reached, for example, 3. It depends on the question, because here in the question I asked you here in question 6, let the crest travel 5 centimeters. I'm gonna let it travel 3 centimeters, and let's see how we are going to measure the speed. So I want you to look at the crest. Okay, I'm going to now forward the time. I'll be forward down again. I have to set the timer first and then forward the time. So this is the timer and forward the time. Let's repeat it again, sorry. So here is the crest till it reach 3. Okay, set the timer and then forward the time till it reach 3. Okay, your eye on the crest till it reach. Now it reached 3. Okay, so it's around 0.50 or 0.52. So how can I measure the speed? Okay, so it will be distance, which is 3 centimeter divided by 0.52. So 3 divided by 0.52, which is around 5.7, which is almost 6 centimeter per second. I can convert it to meter by divided by 100, so it give you 0.06 meter per second. Same speed, same value. That's it, girls. Thank you. And I want you, please, finish all this document, solve it all, and upload it on ManageBack. Good luck.